Maestrapeace, a standing ovation to women's liberation.
A non-negotiable demand for respect.
A dance of detail, a web of resistance.
A healing waterfall of women's love.
A justice-colored vision empowering the poor.
A prayer for every child of the world.
A sister song of praise for our Mother Earth.
And the sweet subversive dream of peace.
It's had a long history. It really is one of the places that are known for being a specific site for second wave feminism. There were many iconic conferences bringing together black women, gay women, different marginalized women who normally don't have a place.
The Women's Building of the Fiso de Mujeres, it's founded by some extremely radical, inspiring, dedicated women in the 70s.
It's still a place that in a very rapidly gentrifying neighborhood remains solidly pro-immigrant, pro-women, pro-community, pro-acting collectively and cooperatively. So to be able to take part in coalitions, to work with other community partners is also a big part of it. And really use our visibility, our longevity, our stability to continue to promote values that we find are universal among women in terms of collectivism, cooperation, compassion, you know, working together.
El edificio de mujeres es un lugar seguro para todo el mundo. Mujeres vienen de diferentes partes del mundo y obtienen servicios.
A resource clinic, which is one of the most popular programs that we have right now, in which we help the community to apply for different benefits or to do some translation of documents.
Those services and tools that they're getting from those offices, those nonprofits, those are things that they can also use in their personal life daily and can also pass on to their loved ones.
It continues to be a source of inspiration, a place to put your talents, a place to develop yourself, a place to get some resources, a place to feel like there's hope, like there's other women out there who can help me and probably have gone through similar things that you've gone through and can sympathize and really are action oriented and help you get from where you are to where you want to go.
Cada año desarrollamos nuevos programas y nuevos servicios en donde queremos que la gente se beneficie de ellos y pueda salir adelante con este empoderamiento y liderazgo.
As a woman, I feel safe to be here. I know that I'm supported. And I feel that anyone that arrives through our doors can personally get that as well.
And in order for it to continue, it can't be taken for granted, and that women and other men and other community members need to help us continue and invest in it, come to our events, volunteer here, help us make sure that the building lasts for a really long time.
The women and the people that work here work so hard to make it the place that it is. The community resource room is open from 10 until about 5, but the work doesn't stop when the lights are off and the doors are closed. You know, this is not just a place where you come in and you clock out. I mean, it's a lifestyle, it's a mindset to want to have a positive impact on the community.
Yo deseo que sigamos expandiéndonos, que nuestros programas sigan creciendo, pero que definitivamente seamos la esperanza y el modelo para muchas otras mujeres y organizaciones que luchan por los mismos derechos.
If women collectively decide X, Y, I mean, they're going to make it happen. And this building is a testament to that. The future's female, the future's feminine, and I think the Women's Building is a big part of that future.